My name is Sylvester McNutt III, and we're going to talk about dealing with change. So the very first thing I want you to do is to look into your life right now and just take a second. Is there a space of change that you're going through? Is there a space of change that's a little uncomfortable? Is there a space of change that's bringing up emotions for you that maybe you don't know how to deal with? Maybe you just recently moved. Maybe you're getting a promotion. Maybe you're starting a new relationship, ending a new relationship, ending an old relationship. Maybe you're starting a project. Maybe you just signed up with a fitness trainer. Maybe you're leaving one. I really want you to look into your life and see where change is. Maybe coming out of a lockdown, going into one, there's so many different potential changes that we can go through. And so for us, what we have to do is we have to really honor what a change is, and we have to be mindful of what happens as we go through change. Because a lot happens at the body level. A lot happens at the soul level when we go through change. A lot can happen in the communal level, right? At the ancestral level, right? At the cosmic level. Like change, a lot of the time we think change can just be what we can directly describe. But the truth is, change that we go through can affect us in more ways than we're even aware of, right? So our work today is to bring change into our awareness so we can really get out of our subconscious mind and bring the change into our conscious mind so we can be aware of how we're relating to change, how we're associating with change, how we're dealing with change, how we're managing change, how we're maybe not managing change, right? Oftentimes with change, there's this thing called shock. If you've ever been in a place where something has happened and you haven't even been able to respond, right? Whether it's excitement or whether it's like, I can't believe that that happened, where you've just been literally in a place of shock. Oftentimes change will create shock, and the shock, it will shock our nervous system. It will shock our body. It will shock our mind. It will shock our soul. And we won't even know how to react. We'll just sit there like. And what that shock is, the shock is your body trying to catch up. It's your mind trying to catch up. That's often why you can't even respond. You just like, you almost feel stuck in a way. And I want to honor that stuckness, because what that stuckness is trying to tell you to do is trying to tell you to say, hey, come totally present to this moment. Come totally, okay, I'm in shock. I'm here, I'm observing what's going on. Right? You see something happen, what's going on? What's happening in this situation? What type of, your body and your eyes are trying to observe the information. Your ears are trying to hear the environment. Your skin is trying to feel, is my skin safe in this environment? Is my body safe in this environment? What's happening? And oftentimes with shock, because shock is oftentimes such a strong thing to deal with, it's such a potent thing to deal with, a lot of the times we will have denial. We won't actually believe the shock. Even though you may see something happening with your eyes, when it's shocking, because it's shocking, you actually don't believe it's happening. And so a lot of the times with change, this is usually like the first layer we're dealing with. We're dealing with shock, and then we're dealing with a denial. Like, is this actually happening? Is this happening to me? Is this happening around me? Is this happening to the person that I'm looking at? Like, is this really happening? And so when you get into shock, and then when you get into the denial, another thing can come up for us when we go through change, which is feelings can come up, right? Change brings feelings, right? And certain feelings can be uncomfortable. So for example, I plan to move at the end of the year. I currently live in Tempe, Arizona, and I wanna move to Florida. I'm not exactly sure yet. I think in Tampa, maybe like Dania Beach, Hollywood Beach area. I was talking with my therapist about this, and he asked me, how do you feel about the change? I said, well, there's two elements that I'm dealing with. There's the element of a deep grief, right? From living in this place in this last year here, there's a big grief that happens, right? Trying to honor the change is going to bring a big grief. And so this whole year for me is a grief ritual. It's a grief ceremony. It's a year for me to honor the grieving part of me leaving, me physically leaving, my soul leaving, the stories that I've developed over the last 8 years leaving, the connections that I've built, the friendships that I've built, and even the ones that have been destroyed through living here, honoring and grieving all of that. But then there's also, so this is what change will do, right? Change brings emotions. So with that, there's the emotion of grief that I'm dealing with as well, because I'm gonna be moving. So change brings grief, but change also can bring fear. So I'm grieving, right? And this is what change is. I'm grieving where I'm at, and I'm grieving that I'm about to leave and I'm about to do this change. But I'm also very afraid, right? I'm also very afraid of the change that's going to come. And it's like, there's this thing in our body where our body may not be able to handle all of those emotions, right? You have fear and you have grief at the same time. It's like, well, how do I manage, right? Can I just pick one? Let me just pick one. But it doesn't work that way. Change does not work that way. And that is why we are so uncomfortable with change, because change brings so many powerful emotions. So for example, in the situation I gave you where I'm gonna be moving, one side of me is going through an extremely powerful grief ritual where I'm trying to honor all of the relationships that I've had in Arizona, where I'm trying to honor all of the experiences that I've had in Arizona, where I'm trying to honor all of the personal growth that I've had in Arizona, where I'm also trying to honor the losses that I've had in Arizona. But at the same time, there's a complete fear that exists. There's a fear of moving to a new place. There's a fear of not making friends. There's a fear of not liking it. There's a fear of loneliness that could seep in, because you'll be moving to a place where, although I do have community, do you really know that? Like, do you really know that you have community? You don't. And that's another element of change. So you have grief, oftentimes you have fear, and then you have unknown. And everybody has a different relationship with unknown. So when you're dealing with potential grief and fear and now unknown, well, that is very uncomfortable for us. That's very uncomfortable for us because we love routine. Our brains are designed from a psychological perspective to love routine. And so when we get out of routine, what's the opposite of routine? Well, routine is unknown, right? It's getting into unknown. It's getting into habits that are new. It's getting into behaviors that are new. It's getting into places that are new. If you were to say, Sylvester, I need to go from this place in Arizona, I don't even need the map. I can just tell you exactly how to get there because I know the streets. I've driven these streets. I know them. I could do the same thing in Chicago where I was born and raised. I could tell you, you could call me right now and say, hey, I'm at this place in Chicago. This is what I'm looking at. How do I get here? And I'll tell you, okay, look, you're gonna wanna get on the Dan Ryan. I can tell you exactly how to do it. But with the move to Florida, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna be lost. I'm gonna be confused. Now, this is another thing that happens with change. Let's keep it in the context of, let's say, driving. Use the parallel of driving to think about your life and to think about the change that you're potentially going through or presently going through. If I'm driving in the streets in Arizona, I'm comfortable, I'm safe. Why? Because I've done this as a routine. I've done this as a habit. There's certainty there. There's confidence there. I can get you anywhere in Chicago. I can get you anywhere in Arizona. Oh, I only got 8 minutes to get there? Cool, I know the side streets to take. I know the traffic flow. I know the long red lights. But when I move to Florida, I don't know. I don't know where the traffic is. I don't know where the side streets are. I don't know how to avoid traffic. I don't even know the street names. I don't know the freeway numbers. So now what happens when I come back into my body that's in Florida, I'll be dealing with the grief of the past year of letting go of this past version of me. I'll be dealing with the fear of moving there. Plus I'll be dealing with the anxiety of the present moment. Now the anxiety may be strong for some, it may be small for some, but there will always be an anxiety present of change because the anxiety in your body simply is just saying, okay, I don't know what this is. I'm anxious about this. Now, my association with anxiety, I'm not saying anxiety is good or bad. I'm actually just saying it's normal. That's a normal experience to be a driver in a new place. And, okay, I don't know this street. Can I turn right here? There's some red lights you can't even turn right at. There's some you can. And so with change brings about a lot of different things in our body. And like I said, change affects you on the body level, the mind level, the soul level. Change affects your boundaries. Change affects your routine. And because change comes, you know, one of my favorite songs actually is A Change Is Gonna Come by Sam Cooke. The reason why that song is so beautiful and so soulful is he's talking about being in a place that's unloving, being in a place that's unwelcoming, being in a place that energetically doesn't feel right for you. And some of us may be in those places. We may be in that type of place with a job. We may be in that type of place with a friendship that we have. We may be in that type of place with our own selves and just our own path. What I love about that song is it invites hope. It invites safety. And he's saying a change is going to come. That's hope. When you are going through a situation that doesn't really vibrate with the life that you want, it doesn't align with you, it doesn't give you the power you need. And that hope of, hey, a change is going to come. It's saying, hey, I want you to be mentally prepared for the anxiety, and I want you to be accepting of the anxiety that may come from this change. I want you to be mentally prepared for and accepting of the grief ritual that you will most likely have to do to honor the change. You know what? I want you to be prepared, and I want you to honor the uncertainty that will come, right? What I love about that song, because it really gives us a template for dealing with change. And the template for dealing with change at some point is acceptance, right? And that's not the first part of the change curve. When you get into a curve of change, right, the bottom is time. Right, that's the bottom axis, is time. So at the very beginning, that's when I mentioned shock. You're gonna have shock. You'll have denial. You'll have uncomfortable feelings. You'll have a bunch of different feelings. Different feelings will come up. You'll get into the uncertainty. Everyone deals with uncertainty different. So when you get into that phase of uncertainty, it's like, okay, well, what emotions are coming up for me right now? What am I feeling? And then allow yourself to like feel into it. You may be perfect with change. You may not be. But if you just feel into it, like, what am I feeling? I feel okay today. Okay, let me just honor that. What am I feeling today? I'm actually overthinking today. Okay, let me feel into that. Why am I overthinking today? What's going on in my body today? Do I have to hold this overthinking? Is this overthinking really the right choice? Sometimes maybe it is, right? It's not necessarily a bad thing. It's really just asking yourself, what's happening? So as you move through time with change, you start going past those things. And then what really happens is you then move to a phase called integration, which is also acceptance. Once you move to integration, those emotions that we often don't make space for, the ones that actually create change, the uncertainty, the fear, the grief, those begin to fade. And those only fade once you honor them and once you acknowledge them. If you try to ignore them, if you try to skip them, if you spiritually bypass those very important emotions and those very important phases, you may not get to integration, right? So that's why it's so important that we be aware of what's happening with change, so we can honor all of that. So we can honor the emotions, we can honor the thoughts, we can honor the anxiety. We don't have to try to get rid of everything that's happening. Let's just honor it. Let's see what's going on, what's happening in this moment. Because once we do that, then we can move to integration, which is acceptance. When integration happens, that's where peace of mind comes in. That's where confidence can come in. And that's not to say that peace of mind and confidence can't occur at the other phases, because they can. You can hold anxiety and peace of mind at the same time. You can. But when integration happens, so integration for me, when I moved to Florida, my integration might not happen the first year. My integration also may happen within the first week. And that's the beautiful thing about change, is it has to happen over time and through honoring the process of all of the emotions that come up. And then once you get to the integration, that's when the peace of mind sets in. That's when the happiness sets in. That's when the calming sets in. That's when your routines get to be what feels like a flow. Your routines feel like they're flowing. So whatever change you're going through right now, I want you to just do a little practice with me. And I want you to just take a second to just kind of come back into your body, right? Come back into your soul, come back into this present moment. And I want you to just observe objectively without judgment. If you're new to my teachings, the number one thing I teach is self-compassion. So let's just go back for a second. And let's just ask ourselves, with self-compassion, no judgment, no beating yourself down, no ignoring whatever emotions you're feeling. Just honestly asking yourself, what change am I going through right now? And how am I dealing with it? And what does that feel like for you? What change am I going through right now? And how am I dealing with it? And it's crucial that the answer is not a judgment of, I'm not doing great, or I'm doing, we're not doing that. We're using self-compassion. So for example, I'll answer the question for myself, just so you can give me an example. Sylvester, I'm dealing with the change of moving to a new place, and I'm scared of the change. I'm choosing to honor and grieve my time here in Arizona. And it's actually beautiful because all of my relationships and friendships here in Arizona are actually becoming more potent and stronger, which is actually making me not want to leave, which causes me more conflict, because who wants to leave good people? Who wants to leave community? However, on the other end, I'm extremely excited about change, and I'm grateful that I have the opportunity to change my life, to try something different. I'm also grateful that there's community in Florida that is willing to make space for me and to hold me and my family and my friends and everything that I have to offer. So in my situation, right, the situation of moving, I'm choosing to hold two things. Like I talked about at the very beginning, I'm choosing to hold the grief, but I'm also choosing to hold on to the excitement of the future. And we can hold on to both. It doesn't have to be one or the other. You don't have to just hold anxiety and not hold the happiness. You can hold both. You don't have to just hold on to the fear and release the excitement. You can hold both. Change allows us to hold and honor multiple emotions. And it's really about just coming back and just saying, okay, what's happening and how am I choosing to honor this? How am I choosing to acknowledge this? How am I choosing to see this? So thank you for joining here today. I really appreciate you all for joining me here on Mind. I believe you can hit the follow button on the Mind app, and also you can subscribe. We'll be starting a new series next week. The series next week on Mind, we're talking about how to communicate better in relationships. Because the truth is, our relationships are everything in life. And it's important that we learn how to communicate, how to listen better, how to listen deeply. So make sure you tune in for the next 4 to 6 weeks with me every single Sunday. And we're gonna be talking all about relationships. And I'll see you all next Sunday.